Oh yeah, we arrived to the big work, which is assemble together the main PCB and the back PCB and the front panel PCB. So for that, the first step, we have to install this 5 PCB to PCB connector between the main board and between the front panel. And no, this tough PCB is sucking a lot of thermal energy, so I have to go on my old lovely way, which is using the desoldering tool as a normal soldering iron, and then this will give me the oh guys, yeah, now we're talking. This is really nice. So you know what guys, I know I will do some kind of explanation what's going on with the circular soldering tip. So this is what is going into the hole. So then if I'm coming with my soldering iron, it has inside a hole, okay, which is a bit bigger than the pin itself. I think it's 1/10 of the millimeter or something like this. So what's happening on a physics? We have here a lot of thermal mass, and because of that, all this area around the pin, including the pin, is get exactly the same temperature. So here the temperature is same, here the temperature is same, here the temperature is same, the pin also. All this area is get hot. And then I adding solder from here, and the surface tension of the solder material under melted condition is really high. So he really like to stick to everything which is friendly for him. For example, copper, silver, gold, whatever. But he don't like the pure iron. He don't like the plastics. He don't like nothing else, only this kind of metals. And when I pull out the desoldering tip, all this area is start to cool down in the same time. So there is no big differences between the top and the bottom, between this point and between this point. So all this is start to cool down together. So what is doing? Of course, the metal is start to shrink, but from every direction in a same time. So then I get a really nice surface, a really nice shiny surface in a top, in a bottom. So what's going on with the normal soldering iron? The heat is coming from here, but you see what's the big difference? This one is heating up only on one side. So this side, for example, this point here, is really far from this one. And let's say you add the solder here, so then the solder of course is start to build up this surface tension fluid, tricky whatever, and then it start to flow also into these areas. But this is what's happened. So the surface tension is true not only around the part and around the copper layer of the PCB, is also true for the soldering iron. So here you will have a distorted surface, and just later on, maybe most let's say 70% of the time everything is going well, but 30% of the time you will never see here a nice surface metal from the solder because of the heat differences. So this melt and metal don't like the cold areas. He just don't wanna flow over there. He really like the hot areas. So then let's say later on the metal start to build up also here. So what's happened when you pull out the soldering tip? Of course, the first time here it's immediately start to shrink, and here this one it's much more hotter than here, and also you have here this distorted surface of the soldering. So when you pull out, this will become something like this. My version it's much more sophisticated on a heat transfer. So for really fine works, for hundreds of legs of same cable or IC or connectors or high precision PCBs, I always like to use my desoldering tool. Yeah, I really like it. So let me switch on the robot. Let me do for you guys some kind of comparison between the two surfaces, if I'm cleaning down the residue or if I'm not cleaning down the residue. Maybe you can see, yeah, like this you can see, absolutely. So this is the flux. So this one, I will clean it down. Just add a bit and start to clean. So I hope it will go well. This connector is cleaned and the other one not, okay? So just look how perfect is this soldering, okay? So right side residue, left side nothing. And no overburn, no burned, like nothing. It's just like it came from some kind of factory. From my factory, from BMR factory, yeah? Solder the 7-pin sockets for the switcher too. So the problem is, so this is not a tight fit. It's not just a simple connector. So this pin socket is unbelievable on engineering. So it has inside, you see this yellow copper something, so it has inside a very small ring which is cutted on one side to the half. Somebody really think of it, yeah? Yeah, this is the perfect shot. So let me turn like this, you see? And also the hole is tapered. Very interesting small puppy. Okay, I think I will apply now other kind of trick. This is actually a flux with the consistency of some kind of fat. So I did this one with the lead fat and this one as dry. Okay? Gone. There. And this lead fat will absolutely disappear under the soldering. So it's not for holding the part until we really finish the solder, just holding the part until we turn the PCB upside down. And this is what now I can do with this Lutfett, yeah? So it's, they will stay on a place, and the paper, this normal, absolutely normal 4 sheet of paper, it just keep the temperature out from my table. So on that way I will not damage my silicone, very nice anti-static soldering, shalala. Yeah, nice, really nice. This is what's happening. So the heat is only came from one side and you can see what's going on. So here the surface tension is good, but on the other side he don't want to run around the part. So the reason for that, you see this really thick, really heavy PCB line here, which is thermal coupled, or I don't know, it's so it can hold and it can suck a lot of thermal energy, even from here far away, just running. If I drop here, yeah, here it's hot in this, so it's like 5 centimeter distance from the part. So this is how the heat is really running away from your heat source. So now we have two options. Or I will rise up the temperature, or I will replace the tip. But to rise up the temperature is not always a good idea, because it's meaning here locally we will have much more higher temperature, which is normal for your soldering. And it also can damage your tip by the time. So this I don't wanna do. So we will replace now again the tip. Now what we have? Same temperature, total same temperature, but much more bigger thermal mass. Okay, so let's add a bit solder. And no problem at all. Okay, so maybe you guys also can see the quality of this soldering. I think it's okay. It's really nice. Next step, add R1 to R143. So 143 piece of resistor I have to do a soldering, except one, which is on a front PCB. Oh my god, and also I have to check the documentation if the resistors are marked like NC, which is mean not connected in a part list, should be not installed. So it will be a really long, boring job. You know what, guys? Let now choose which step I will show you. You know what, this we can do now, because it will not bother other parts. When the panel is big and the DIY project is complicated, so it has a lot of parts, don't think it will be not boring, yeah? It's there is few steps which is really interesting, but there is other steps which is really boring and you just work like I think this one is belongs to the main CPU. You see this mark here, a same intendation. Okay, you see here, so these two has to match, because otherwise, if you solder this one reverse, yeah, like this, then when you came with the IC, exactly in a very bad position, this is a CPU, okay, you can imagine, then you came with your CPU, and you install your CPU reverse, because you just see this one, you don't see the original mark which is on the PCB, yeah? So this you cannot see, and because of that it's really easy to kill and kill and kill and just drop a new IC, drop a new IC, and then you wonder what the fracky is going on here. And you know how I know this? Because one time I did. So yeah, I paid a really high price for it, so don't do my mistake, yeah? Let's start the robot. Really nice design, guys. Let me show you why. We have a multiple positioning, yeah? So first, you have this one, this intendation. Then you have a dot, which is always signature for the first leg. And also, maybe you can see like this way, this one's circular. And this one is not circular. So even if you do some mistake, you have 1, 2, 3 check. And also, it's true on other side. Round, square. Very nice. Thank you very much, guys in the Sound Sculpture, really. The Sound Sculpture selling this monitor controller on two price. So one price is this DIY kit, and the other price is the fully built monitor controller. So if you are DIY idiota like me, then definitely you must go on the DIY kit way. This big size of DIY projects, when you run through the whole of the documentation here, yeah? And you run through the semantics, you can learn a lot. Sorry for my dirty finger, but today I repaired the two car. Yeah, so from resistor networks we don't have more. Here I find one easy peasy, which is, I think this is the main power input connector. Each component hole is not just a component hole, it's a via hole. So via is meaning the signal is jumping from one side to the other. So if the solder is not fully nice on other side, don't worry, because this is a via hole. Angry pixies can jump from here to the other side. This one, it need a kind of attention, because if you solder this one on a wrong direction, you do a shortcut. Okay, again, double check, because this can cause even fire. Our part is organized in this direction. Yeah, we did a mistake. So the front side connectors is on the solder side. Oh my God. So let's now try out this this soldering tool on a hard way. So many legs. Let's apply some very small brute force, yeah. So guys, I did a very big mistake. I soldered the front panel connectors on a wrong side. Continuous line here, for example. But this one, it's a dotted line, so it's meaning you have to install the part on the other side. Yeah, I'm stupid, so let me repair my error. What they suggest you to do after you drop the connector here, then add the front panel connector to the end. In that way, it will hold up your connector on a right height. You guys like my mistakes, eh? You can laugh on me. Now is the time is to clean up the mess after this idiot who did this double rework. So now we finishing the headphone jack PCB. Really nice. Oh, this is some kind of special. So here is the front input jack PCB. And this has some kind of really weird solution. How we should connect it. You know when it will be a nightmare? If you have to replace this jack connector. I think this is the headphone amplifier potmeter. Okay, so now the connector is installed and this really nice Burns potmeter also installed. It has a bit dry feeling, but maybe I will modify them with additional high viscosity silicone fat, what I have for specially for shafts and for potmeters. But I'm 100% sure this is a high quality pot from Burns. This is the big body blue line. It's almost absolutely top notch. Go back to the front panel. What we find here more? Okay, so the 7-segment displays are installed. And the next one is the switches. This is the Burns encoder. Kind of ready. Not kind of, this is actually ready. Yeah? Guys, I can play all the day with this. So what we finished today, we installed a few parts into the main PCB. We installed also the front panel connectors to the bottom of the PCB, yes. And then we finished completely these small PCBs with the volume controller, with the headphone jack connector, and with the back side something connector. And we finished the front panel fully. I only have two things to do. One is to clean the residue from the flex. And the next one is to check this washer here, because I'm not sure about this one. Maybe it's in another bag. You see, here I also have some washers. That's all for today. I hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you for watching, and see you tomorrow. Bye.